brought to you by Lared. Have you gotten an updated COVID-19 vaccine? Well, the updated vaccine offers protection from circulating variants. You can give them a call at 302-855-1233. They also have locations in Georgetown, Seaford, and also Milford. Breezy and much cooler today. Sunny with highs in the mid-40s.
All right, we got some FMLs coming up. So if you have any you want to add in, you know, F My Life moments, 302-858-5117.
Oh, boy.
You can call or text those in. Before we get into that, I want to get into this. This is coming from our partner, 47ABC, our news partner, our guy Rob Petrie reporting. Worcester County residents react to school violence allegations as district prepares for response.
They're concerned.
Here we go.
Meanwhile, in Worcester County, community members say they're concerned to hear that violence is spiking in public schools. 47ABC's Hannah Cicchini joins us here live in studio with those details. Hannah, tell us, what's the update here?
Rob, yesterday, Worcester County State's Attorney and Sheriff told us that you're more likely to be assaulted in a Worcester County public school than anywhere else in the county.
Hold on. Am I hearing that right? What did I miss? What happened?
Statistics. This has been like an ongoing thing.
Okay. Well, how are you feeling? I didn't know about this.
But okay, let's just finish with the story and then I'll comment. Okay.
Now, this morning, the Worcester County Board of Education held a special and closed meeting to figure out how to respond to those harsh accusations. Among law enforcement's complaints are alarming statistics showing that assaults and bullying in the school district have skyrocketed since 2019, despite multiple recommendations made by police on how to put a stop to the trend. Law enforcement is placing blame on the school district for not implementing those recommendations and doing more to curb the violence. Now, community members that I spoke with, meanwhile, say they're upset hearing about these allegations.
I was surprised, yeah. But when I saw it, I was even more surprised when they showed the clips, because that was violent.
In some instances, it's poor parenting. Kids don't have limits anymore. They seem to think they're entitled, and it's getting out of hand, I think.
Now, others who I spoke with who did not want to be shown on camera agreed with those sentiments, calling the situation shocking. I asked those that I spoke with, as parents themselves, what do they think needs to be done to end the violence? Well, some said it starts with the parents. Others said the school district also has a big responsibility.
I think it's a balance. It's hard for teachers to enforce stuff that isn't enforced at home, so they have a hard job.
They're learning that from somewhere. I don't think they went to school and learned it. I think they learned it before they got there. There needs to be more consequences when it happens, or worse consequences maybe.
Now on Friday, Worcester County Public Schools officials will be holding a press conference to provide their response to law enforcement's complaints. But for now, live in studio, Hannah Cicchini, 47ABC, WMDT.
All right, so I don't even know how to respond to that. I mean, we hear about, you know, stuff going on in schools all the time. Not just Worcester County, all over, you know, and people can say, oh, it starts at home, it starts at home, it starts at home. Yeah, of course. But we're not going to these kids' homes and changing the way that they're being parented. So how do you...
But what is happening with the violence?
I guess they're talking about fights.
Has there been fights, bullying? Like, what is happening?
Yeah, I mean, I know that there's bullying. I know for a fact that there's bullying. Mm-hmm. And that sometimes things don't get done. I know that for a fact.
Well, that's not good.
No, it's not good.
That's a shame.
But I don't think, and this is just my opinion, I could be wrong. I think it's all schools. I think it's all kids. I don't think that it should be pinpointed on just Worcester County.
Okay.
Maybe that's the...
But why is it making the headlines? Did something happen?
apparently there's stats that are, that have been released. And for, you know, I don't know. Maybe we should open up the phone and text
line.
Is
there pictures, videos? Is there, I mean, like, what has happened to make it come to light? I don't know.
302-858-5117 if you want to comment on this. You know, maybe that's just the Decatur in me, like, coming out, like, defending my school. You know what I'm saying?
Well, yeah. Like, I mean, if you have kids in that district, and not just one, you've had all your kids are going through that district.
Yeah,
so.
And there's lots of drama that goes on in high school. And there's stuff that's going on that I don't agree with, and things that have been handled. There's also other things, you know, with my son now that I love and that is great, and you know.
Wow.
So I would like to know what they need to be disciplined more. Like what? What can you do to discipline the kids more? Send them home? You know what I'm saying? Like, is that the answer? I don't know. Sending them home more often? Yeah, suspending them more often? You're just giving them a day off, vacation.
I don't know.
Like, that's the thing.
You know, all of the procedures as far as it goes with, you know, they get written up, then a write-up goes to in-school suspension. Suspension leads to being suspended out of school. What happens if you get into a physical fight?
Let's see, 359 texting in. Hey, can y'all play Double Dutch Bus?
Yes.
That's old.
Remember
that's old
Thursday.
School.
Look at you.
I agree, Bill. It's all kids. 756. Whoa, this is horrible. 603. Let's see. Granddaughter. My granddaughter, who's 11, and three kids got fighting right in the middle of class. Is it because of that school? Though is that like, or is it because of
what school district? You don't have to tell us the school, but it's
Worcester.
Is. Oh,
but is it because of school? Is it because of the school itself, or is it because of those certain kids? You know what I'm saying? I don't know. Let's see, 344. It's not just Worcester, y'all. You're right, Bill. Look what happened at the Cape versus Sussex after in the parking lot basketball game a few days ago. Yeah, and again, I'm not trying to call that Cape versus Sussex because they're great schools also.
Gosh, what is happening or what has happened or what's the change?
352 texting in. It may be the parents, but it's also no consequences. My granddaughter was bullied several times last year and this year. She was called a racist name, and the school called, and the kid did it, had autism. I never heard of autism causing you to make racist comments. Won't say which school in Worcester, but they have repeatedly done nothing but make excuses. My son goes to, and I'm not calling out the schools.
No.
When you guys to send in the schools, I'll just say the district. Let's see. My son goes to Wicomico schools, I'll say. Three separate occasions students have attacked teachers just this year. So that's not Worcester. That's another school.
And the students are attacking the teachers at that particular incident.
At that incident.
Not
just, kids are going wild attacking teachers.
No, at that incident.
Yeah, at that incident.
What they're talking about, that's what happened.
Let's see, 242. It is a notorious blind eye mentality from staff. The kids know that they can get away with being jerks. Are admin unsupportive of discipline? Well, what kind of discipline? What more do they do? I'm just asking. What more do they do?
Wow. Well, I mean, what is done? Is it a call home, a meeting home? They get sent home. How long is the suspension? Like, what are the consequences?
235. Instead of sending them home, give them community service.
Okay.
Have them clean up the outside the school grounds. How about that? Can they do that? Is that a thing?
But it's something to look into. If it's another avenue.
I want to see stats compared to Worcester, Wicomico, Somerset, Sussex, of all, like, you know, things that happen, fights and all that. I mean, because school fights have been going on since we've been in school.
Yeah.
Forever.
Wow.
Yeah, the bullying is sad and needs to stop and needs more consequences. I absolutely agree.
With the bullying?
The bullying, yes. Yes, yes, yes. I'm a strong advocate because I've, you know, personal experiences with dealing with that. Not going to go into any detail on that.
Yeah.
But, and things should have been done. They weren't handled correctly. To where it was not good.
That's a shame.
But I don't think it's the only, it's just because of that, because of the school. I think it happens in all schools.
Right.
Maybe no, certain people does. Who work at the school didn't handle certain things the way that they should have. But there's other people at other schools that do the same thing. You know?
Wow.
Bill, it's not just Worcester. I work in the public schools in another county, and it's off the chain.
Yeah, okay.
Okay? Thank you for saying that. Thank you for checking in.
And bullying, I mean, I know you didn't have a great experience, but what is the procedure?
Well, there's a lot of blind eyes turned. Yes, there is in certain instances.
That's a shame.
But again,
that's a shame.
Is it at all schools? You know? Is progressive discipline causing soft consequences and multiple chances for kids instead of zero tolerance? Don't know. Let's see. 756. I agree. Not just one district or state. Our society is full of violence and anxiety in our youth and scary times. Hard to know what to do. I like community service. I think it's a great idea. Let's see. It's 603. It's middle school where they're attacking teachers. They are moved out of the teacher's class and just put in another class. That's it.
Right. Like, what is the consequence?
339. Need to bring the paddle back. Okay.
I've heard that several times. Okay. Every time we get into this discussion, someone says that.
Yeah, bring the paddle.
Good
okay.
morning. Power 1017.
You're live on the air.
Good morning.
Hey, good morning. Now, before you make your comment, I don't want to call out any particular school.
Right.
And, you know, I don't want to call, I mean, you can mention districts and stuff, but I don't want to call out any this certain school, teacher, absolutely. Person, all that. But go ahead.
No, I was actually going to call out my son.
Okay. Oh, well, okay. Hey, there you go.
Yeah. So just recently an incident happened with my son. He's a sixth grader.
Okay.
So he was bullying these other boys that are very, very humble. No matter how he talks to them, treats them, they always ask him, you know, let's hang out, go to the park, blah, blah, blah. It got out of hand. And I found out, and he lied to me. So now my son is paying consequences. That is one thing. I'm with you, Bill. I do not tolerate bullying. I hate it. Mm-hmm. I hate it with a passion. And my son decided that it was going to be cool because somebody else is actually bullying him.
Mm-hmm.
So he figures instead of him standing up to that other one, that he can actually use that and bully other kids.
Mm-hmm.
And that's something that, it infuriated me. It just happened a couple of days ago. So I told him, since you can't value and appreciate what you have here, when my dad comes, which is his grandfather who lives in Texas, all the way down south, it's a desert, I said, you're going with him in the summer. You need to learn and value and appreciate the friends that you do have here and learn and value and appreciate what you do have here. Because down there is nothing. There's nowhere to go. If I've been there, there's nowhere to go. That is your lesson. I took away his Xbox, took away AirPods. Only reason why he has his phone is because I have the app, the Life 360, to keep track of him. But it is getting, it really is getting out of hand, and it infuriates me. And he knows I hate bullying. He knows that is not tolerated. I do not tolerate it. I reached out to the school counselor. He came home yesterday. He told me that the school counselor did talk to him, sat down with him. I mean, he's going through therapy. We're doing a lot of things. I'm not stopping. I'm going to keep hitting this until it actually triggers, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Until it registers mm-hmm. in his head before it gets worse. I'm one of those moms. I will not sugarcoat my son. My son is not a victim. He's definitely not a victim. I will not sugarcoat him. I know what I have in my house. And I just wanted to point that out. That it's funny. I just turned the radio on. And we just went through this the other day. So he's still on punishment. No birthday party for him because he's turning 12 next week. Unfortunately, I'm trying to cancel everything. And I told his friends, if y'all want to talk to him in school, that's one thing. I can't stop it. But I recommend you guys start thinking twice before you become friends with him again. I'm sorry, but he's got to learn his lesson.
Is it fair to call student fights like, I mean, student fights have been going on since we were in school. You know, I mean, kids tussle, they get in fights in the hallway, you know. So I remember being in class in ninth grade English and someone jump across the desks, you know, in a fight. I remember that. Gosh. So you got to think, I'm 42. So how long ago was that? You know what I'm saying? I remember that. I'll never forget that moment. But nowadays that happens and they're like, oh, that's going to go down as a stat with, and by the way, they had and back then, I don't remember the resource officer running down to the classroom and putting the person in cuffs. I feel like that's what happens nowadays.
Right.
So is it fair that now I understand that they should, you know, like be more cautious. We're in 2024, whatever, but is it fair to say like when something like that happens, it's violence. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's a little school fight. Like, I don't know.
I don't know if I agree with that 100%.
I'm just asking.
Yeah, I don't know if I can agree with that 100%.
It's better for their officer to run down and cuff them.
Yeah.
If they get in a fight.
In some situations.
Okay.
Only because I have seen some videos. And if I was an administrator, if I was a teacher, if I was a school nurse, if I was the office.
Yeah.
You know? I'm not big enough. I wouldn't be able to hold my own against some of these kids. Honestly, they're big, they're grown, they're strong, and they're going at it. I mean, some of the videos I've seen.
Yes,
I would
correct.
I would need help.
Well, I remember.
Backup, so I can't go, oh, it's just a little school fight, because like they're really fighting.
Yeah, they are.
And they're like out to hurt each other.
Well, I remember back in the day.
And me coming down saying, kids, hey, no. You know, that's not going to work.
Well, I just remember back in the day, like, I don't know. I feel like today it's more like, well, if they're 18, they can get a charge and they can get arrested. I don't remember ever having that conversation when we were in high school. Like it was always like, well, high school kids fighting. Mm-hmm. Like teachers ran in and broke it up. Done. I don't remember. And again, I know a lot of it has to do with social media and the videos and everything, you know, that circulate and it gets on Snapchat and then the bullying and then, you know, like all that. I think that has a lot to do with where we are today.
Yes. And I feel like the kids nowadays, it's like when they fight, like you said, Jessica, when they fight, it's like they have so much anger that
I don't think it's an easy fight. Yeah. It's not an easy fight to break up.
Aggressiveness out in just one fight. And it's scary, and it's crazy, it's scary, it's out of control, and they are just kids. In the end, they are just kids, but at the same time, I mean, you got to pay for consequences. I'm sorry, but you're not a 5-year-old.
So what consequence?
You're not no little toddler.
What consequence does the school do?
Oh, my goodness.
Because everybody says they got to be tougher, so what?
Yeah, they do.
Then what's that mean?
As far as tougher, I don't know. I wish.
Right. That's the answer. Yeah, we don't know. Everybody says we don't know. Because
they have to have a plan. They have to put something, you know, in mind that's going to actually teach. I really couldn't even say. I'm not even sure, like, you know, what kind of plan they should have in place. But the fact of the matter is, it is getting out of control where the, you know, students are fighting a lot more aggressive. They're coming back for revenge and things like that. It's just getting out of control.
And then you know what happens also? Somebody's bullied until they've had enough. And then they snap and they lash out. But then the school comes down on the person who has been bullied for so long because nothing's been done. And then they're the ones who look like they're the aggressor. But really, they've been bullied for so long. They've had enough. And then, you know, you got the parents who are like, yes, finally they take up for themselves. But then the school's like, nope. You know,
right?
So
I feel like as a parent, so I talk to my son and I ask him all the time, "Are you being bullied? Is somebody being bullied? You know, somebody bullying you? Because you know, I don't tolerate it. So it's not acceptable that if somebody's bullying you, that you go and take that anger out and take it out on somebody else that's not even doing anything to you. That's not fair to them. So if somebody's bullying you, you need to tell me now so I can address the issue because I don't have a problem addressing the issue." I'm not trying to be, I'm not trying to cause a fight with the other child's parents, no. But I am going to take the steps necessary to make sure that it's not becoming a cycle because that's exactly what it is. It's a repetitive cycle. you know, somebody bullies you, you bully somebody else, they bully somebody else, and it's never ending.
Yeah.
So, I always talk to my child. That's the main thing. You got to communicate. You got to know the signs. And I knew something had happened the other day. That's how I know my son. I'm very observing, you know, of my child. So when I know he comes in that house and he's quiet after he's been hanging out with his friends, something happened. And I'm going to find out one way or another, whether it's calling, you know, his friends, which I did, and they told me what happened. You know, I'm not going to stop there. Something's got to give. So,
thanks for checking in. We appreciate it, okay?
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Hey, you want to comment? We're getting so many text messages in. I think we're going to keep this conversation going because I want to go over some of you guys, what you guys are saying on the text. If you want to call in, you want to chime in, 302-858-5117. We'll continue. Throwback Thursday. We got a 47 ABC update coming up at 732.